उमा जी, यू आर एबल टू हियर? यू आर ऑन म्यूट।
She is on mute. She is.
Yeah, I'm ready now.
Okay.
You are ready?
Yes.
So we can enter everyone who is waiting?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Green group ma'am, the message have put.
Yeah.
Amma, this session start and the join madren.
Hakin.
And what about the PPT?
PPT you need to use Deepak.
Okay.
Only I will be telling, okay?
You are able to hear? You are on mute.
Are you able to hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm ready now.
Okay.
Yeah.
You are ready?
Yes.
So we can enter everyone who is waiting?
Yes. Yeah.
Your voice, my voice is looking. And what about the PPT?
You need to mute every Deepak. You need to mute everybody. Okay, otherwise no, there will be a lot of chaos behind. Who is there? Who is talking?
Are you able to hear me?
कौन बात कर रहे हैं?
वही इको आ रहा है. मैं थोड़ा सेटअप चेंज कर चेक करता हूँ, कुछ गड़बड़ हो रहा लगता है.
कौन बात कर रहा है?
वही देख रहा हूँ मैं, कुछ सेटअप में इश्यू आ रहा है.
सबका म्यूट करो ना, सबको म्यूट करो ना. वो अनलेबल परमिशन मत दो.
म्यूट एवरी दीपक, यू नीड टू म्यूट एवरीबॉडी. ओके, अदरवाइज नो, देयर विल बी लॉट ऑफ
चैट्स बिहाइंड. यस
यस यस, आई थिंक इट्स कमिंग फ्रॉम YouTube. दीप्ति, इट्स कमिंग फ्रॉम YouTube. आई थिंक टू प्रोबेबली रिपीटिंग.
कौन बात कर रहे
हैं? वही इको. हां, YouTube से आ रहा. थैंक यू, YouTube से आ रहा था. दैट वाज द इशू.
अरे सबको म्यूट करके रख दो दीपक, नहीं तो ठीक नहीं होगा ये सेशन.
नाउ इट इज फाइन, नाउ इट इज फाइन. कस्टमर्स,
वी बिलीव इन सिंपलिसिटी, सो डेवलपर्स, स्टार्टअप्स एंड
नाउ इट इज फाइन, नाउ इट इज गुड. थैंक यू. योर यूट्यूब से ही आ रहा था, तो अब हम लोग का ठीक हो गया. ओके, देन आई विल एंटर इट. अनम्यूट योरसेल्फ. Hello all, we are starting in very soon.
53 participants.
Shall we start, Deepak?
Yes, we can start it. 1 minute more will take.
You put the YouTube connection to the group, no?
Yes. One minute more you give it because few people are also joining.
You do that by simultaneously you can put, no?
That link I have shared already. I will share it again, okay?
Share it again. How many are there in the group now? How many are there in your Zoom?
55.
Who is there behind talking?
No one.
No, somebody told 55, no?
I told.
No, lady, who is the lady?
No, I am participants ko dekh
ke. Oh, acha.
Okay, all of you please switch on your cameras. Yeah, please.
Umaji, in between the demo, you are allowing to take the questions or at the end? Or you are mute? You are mute. Umaji, are you talking on mute?
Let them raise their hand, otherwise it becomes a lot of disturbance. There are so many people, no?
Yes. So I will make everyone mute, okay?
If anything is there, let them put it in the chat because exactly. Lot of people are there here. It becomes a chaos then later.
So this is
put them everybody to the mute.
Yes.
Put them everybody to the mute.
Sure. I'm doing.
Yes, please, all of you switch on your cameras. Okay, shall we start, Deepak?
Yes, we are good to go.
Yeah.
Okay, so hello everyone. Yeah, thanks a lot for showing the interest. We are just now starting this session about the vermicompost, and with us we have the Uma Dharmaraj. Many of you might be knowing she has done wonderful session last time about the how to make the very easily you make the vermicompost. So she is along with that, she is doing the art of living activity, and she has associated with social activity from long time. So rule of this discussion is that because there are so many people, whenever you have doubt, you put questions in the chat. At the end, we will take the questions on the voice also. Uma ji?
Yeah.
Over to you. We are good to start.
Can you spotlight me? Yeah. Namaste, everybody. I'm very happy that you all people have showed interest and you are all here. We'll be having 1 hour of session, okay? Then later, 15, 20, half an hour, I will take the any questions are there. So is it okay, everybody? 1 to 1.5 hours? You can show the thumbs up, yeah. Yeah. So before starting the vermicompost, I would like to give some little bit of introduction about the vermicompost. What is vermicompost and what is this earthworms? We will, according to PPT, we will go through that. Huh? And I am doing this vermicompost from 3 years, and I am sharing my experience. There are so many ways of doing this vermicompost. So whichever is very easy to do, and whichever is very comfortable for the households, all those things I'm taking care. So we will start now. Huh? And you all people know my name is Uma Santosh Dharmaraj, and I'm also Art of Living teacher. And I teach happiness programs, and I take meditations, yoga, and all those stuff. By the side, this is my passion of gardening, and I thought, let me teach people about the vermicompost, because so many people doesn't know, and there are a lot of things are in the YouTube, and they show so many things, and we don't know which to take the method and how to go ahead, and somebody should be there to hold our hands and tell us, so this is the way you can do it, and if anything happens, if any difficulties are there, somebody should be there with us to guide us. Okay, so after this vermicompost workshop, we will all together, we all of us, for I will be giving 1 month of time, 15 days or 10 days for collecting all your earthworms, wherever you get, and you can collect it, and then later we will set up the containers. You buy some containers, any tub is okay. I will show you all the whatever things need to be taken care. Any nearby shop, one tub, you can take it. If it is there at home also, it's okay, you can take. And I will take in detail and very simple way, not very confusing. In a simple way, we can learn the vermicompost. Is it okay, everybody? I will tell you where to collect and which earthworms you need to really look for. All the stuff, we will look into it today. Good? Yeah. Deepak, shall we start with the PPT?
Yes. I will share the screen.
And Deepak is a volunteer of Art of Living, and he is a scientist, and also he's a software engineer, and always he is helping nature, and whenever I call him, he'll be there with me for the presentation and whatever it is, whenever we take the courses, and also we take the courses for children also. He's really available. He is like, you know, Hanuman for me. So thank you so much. And Subhash ji is there with us, and he is sharing this Zoom link and all those stuff. And he is also a teacher, and he is also software engineer. We all are very busy, but we thought little bit we make you time for you people and take some sessions for you all.
Yeah. Thanks a lot for introduction. We are seeing the screen.
Can you people see the PPT?
Yes.
Yeah.
So we are good to go.
Yes. So the agenda is we will be taking all these steps, okay? Benefits of vermicompost and brief about earthworms and vermicompost and 5 essentials of vermicompost and steps for preparation, harvesting vermicompost, and do and don'ts. That's it. Okay, next. So you all people know what is vermicompost, and it is very much benefited to people who are doing gardening or also who are doing farming. It has very important is it has lot of microorganisms and bacteria, which is really very good for the soil and for the plants. And it also take care of the immunity, what you say, and resistance for the insects and all your diseases. And you say, you know, this is organical, and so many things are there, and doesn't have any. And one more, what I would like to say is, it has nitrogen, phosphorus, potash, zinc, manganese, calcium, all the stuff, whatever in a small amount, whatever you want for the plants, everything is available here. So that is a very much important in this, and also very good for germination. And if you put this to the plants, even though if you put little more, more also, it doesn't burn the plant. So this is the beauty of this vermicompost. Cow dung and all, no, if you don't know how to use it, if you put little bit, then finish. The plant will start dying. So here in the vermicompost, it doesn't have that, it doesn't burn the plants. That is the very beauty of this vermicompost. Okay. Yeah, next. Here I have selected two earthworms. One is red wigglers and one more is African night crawlers. And one more is Indian blue. Indian blue is of our Himalayan earthworms. Recently, it is been using in other countries, and here is not much in use. And these two are the why I'm using is that actually these are, they have come from other country, but for commercial basis, everywhere they are using these two earthworms. And wherever you go for you to buy, generally you get these two earthworms only. So if you are in native place, if you are there in the farm, if you are not using any this one, what is that, any DAP or urea, all those stuff, then generally you will get to get your local varieties. So what I suggest is, get the earthworms whichever are available in your area, in your city, in your state, because they are already adjusted to the this one, to your area, to your temperature. Even may, it may be red wigglers only, but red wigglers in Bangalore, they are adjusted to our temperature. In Chennai, red wigglers, they have been adjusted to that nature, to the temperature. So better take from your area itself. So because if you order from the Amazon, what happens, they will be sending from somewhere else. So if you bring to your place, and if they don't adjust, then they will perish and they'll die. So make sure that you use whichever is suitable for your place. And these multiply very fast. Which one? These red wigglers and African night crawlers and this Indian blue, these all will multiply very fast. Even our Indians are also very much very good. It is not like that multiplying and laying cocoons. All are very much good and best for us, because this quality of vermicompost is very good, better than this red wigglers and ANC. I will be calling this ANC. So whichever you get it, please take it. Okay. Yeah, next. And I am showing this this one vermicompost. To the left hand side, the person who is holding the vermicompost is made out of red wigglers. You can see the difference. That looks like this tea powder. And to the in the between, that is from my this one container, that is ANC, African night crawlers, this one vermicompost. It looks like black rice. It is long in, it is very, it is long. So I think so you people will be knowing this casting of this earthworms is vermicompost, because so many people won't be knowing that, so I'm mentioning it. So the earthworms casting is this one vermicompost, and it smells very good. It is earthy smell. You can hold in your hand, and it is not a very dirty, and it has lot of microbes and bacteria, and it doesn't harm you, or it doesn't any irritation for your skin, nothing. You can touch your vermicompost. If you are not at all okay, then you can use your gloves. Okay, now it comes, this is the most important in this session. Yes, you need to be pakka with these five elements. What that is: container, material, food, worms, and environment. If you are very good in these five, then my workshop is done. So please note down these five things. Container is very important, material is very important, food, worms, and environment. So let us see the containers. See, containers should not be cylindrical in shape, not vertical. It should be horizontal, because a lot of aeration should be there for the earthworms, because we'll be feeding them and the temperature will be changing, summer, winter, and all those stuff. If there is a lot of heat is accumulated in the container, then they will suffocate. Either they will die or they will come out of the containers. So this is a very important. That's why specifically I have taken these tubs, which are very broad in mouth. Diameter is very big, and also I have taken the crater. So in with either crater or tub, you please take it. Not any drums, please. Because drums are long and mouth are very small. And if we don't keep put completely at the bottom, we'll be putting on the top and they cannot come out when they want to breathe. So all those stuffs will happen and they will perish. So even in the commercial way also, they use this horizontal grow bags or whatever it is. They don't go in vertical, cylindrical. So please look into it. This is very, very important to begin with. Okay, yeah, next. I'm a very fast people. Can you catch up? Okay, no?
Yes.
Should I slow down a little bit?
No, it's okay, Maju.
Yeah. And the material, yeah. There are so many materials people say about that. But yeah, please go back, Deepak. Cardboard, cocoa peat, dry leaf, and soil. These four things I have chosen and have used it. Why I'm taking these four things is, these four things have capacity of holding the water, moisture, and also it keeps the container cool. It has that cooling capacity. It has a cooling, nature. So, and they are very close to nature also. So you can either use two, not single, not one. Either two. Cardboard and leaf is the best, I tell you. Cardboard and leaf is the best. And you can go with coco peat and soil. If you go with coco peat and soil, you need to put half portion of coco peat and half portion of soil. If you get this one, dry leaves, then add dry leaf also. Okay. And you can take dry leaf and cocoa peat. See, you cannot take dry leaf alone because of this air and all those stuff, they dries very fast. So something is needed to bind to the leaf so that it keeps moist. So cardboard or cocoa peat or soil, anything will go very well with the leaf. So any two of them, you can take it and you can start. And in this material, earthworms, immediately they will settle down and they will become very comfortable, because these four things are very favorite of these earthworms. So that's why I'm taking this material and I have used it. Okay, yes, next. So this is the cardboards. Yes, next. And one more thing I would like to tell about the cardboards. This cardboard, what happens, it absorbs the water and also they lay eggs in between the layers of this cardboard. So you need to keep on adding some cardboards and some leaf whenever is needed in the container. So please look into it. These two things is whichever bed you use in the beginning, But in later, you better you use keep adding this cardboard and this dry leaves. That is very much essential, and they love these two materials, and also they poop very fast, and you'll get a lot of vermicompost. So be sure about the cardboards and this one. Yeah, next. And you people know about the cocoa pit, but some people don't know it is made out of this what is that, coir of this this one, coconut, and you get it in the square shape or rectangular shape. You need to put it in water, and when it becomes wet, then it volume will be increased to 5:1:5. If you bring 5 kg of not 1:5 more, if you bring 5 kg of this one cocoa pit, it volume increases to 25 kgs. So thoroughly you need to wash it. Sometimes the people will put some salts or something like that, and also it has to be completely, it should be wet before using this cocoa pit. Yes, yeah, next. Yeah, dry leaf, and you need to soak this dry leaf for 2-3 days so that it becomes soft before you use it, and remove the extra water, and you can use it for the bed. And if you are using this dry leaf, you need to keep sprinkling water for 1 week. Then only later you release the earthworms. I'll come into that demo and everything later. Yes. Now soil, you can use soil, which soil you have to use, that is garden soil. If you are using ready potting mix, then please don't use it, because now we don't know what they are adding. Sometimes they add urea, DAP, all those stuff. If urea, DAP is there in the soil, then they don't like the atmosphere at all. They will come out. That's why in the field or in the farm, why these earthworms are perishing is because they are adding this all DAP, urea, all those stuff. That's why they are not surviving in the farm. So please make sure, if you are using potting mix, don't take soil from your garden. Only if at all it is organic, then only you take it from your pots or from your farm. Yeah, next. Now food, most important. Yeah, please. Food, what we need to do, better you know what you should not put it in the container. That if you know, then you will be knowing what you need to put it in the container. Non-veg will not go into the container. Cooked food will not go into the container. And bakery items, bread, whatever it is, whatever you see in the bakery, biscuits, all those stuff will not go into the container. And masala, any garam masala is left out, all those stuff will go into the compost, not into the earthworms bin. And one more thing is cooked food, and one more thing is milk products. So these 3-4 things you should be careful. No non-veg, no cooked food, no bakery items, and no milk products, and no oils. And no fried things. Paneer bach gaya, nahi dalne ka. Theek hai? Curd bach gaya, nahi dalne ka. That all will go into your compost bin, not here. Then what we need to put in the vermicompost bin? Your vegetable peels, fruit peels, tea waste, and coffee waste, all those powders, coffee powder, tea powder will go into, that is very favorite. And fruit peels will go. Please avoid citric fruits. See, now it is a mango season. Now you bring lot of 1 kg, 2 kgs of mangoes. 1 or 2 peel of mango peels is okay. If you put it in half a bucket of mango peels in the this one bin, what happens? The acidic will increase. All is citric, this one will not go into the bin. all everything, whatever. Now you will be thinking, then what is there to use? You need to put it in the whatever you eat now. All vegetables you are eating, that waste will go. And whatever your this one is there, watermelons are there, all everything, brinjal, bhendi, apple, pumpkin, what all you will eat, that all will go into the this one.
Maji, are you there?
I am there. I want to show my this one. वो नहीं आ रहा है.
हाँ, I have to stop the share. If you
zoom पे कर रहे तो वो आता था ना मेरा. Then how shall I show that otherwise?
Or later you can show after this theory.
Okay, fine. Yeah. So got it, no? Yes, next. Wait one second. Eggshells. Yeah, you can put eggshells also in this containers. So tea, everything is taken care. Yes, okay. Yes, next. So what about these worms? Worms won't like direct sunlight, and they need moist container, means moist bed, because they breathe through their skin. So the container should be moist. The container should not dry. So keep checking once or twice in a week how it is going on, and cover it with a cloth, wet cloth. So what happens? And you need to cover it with the container with the cardboard, and inside you need to cover it with the wet cloth. Anything, it may be your cotton sarees or your Turkey towels, bed sheet, even your pure kurtas made out of cottons. Cut karo sleeve ko, to usko use kar sakte hain. Cut your sleeves and use it. It should be pure cotton, no synthetic cloths. Okay, I will be showing you demo all those stuff. So they breathe through their skin, so the container should be moist. Then only they can leave, otherwise they will die. So this is very important for the earthworms. We don't actually call them worms, we call them earthworms. These are not like other worms. They are very friendly to the environment, and they are very friendly to the farmers. So Deepak, you need to change it to worms to earthworms next time.
Yes.
We don't call them worms, we call them earthworms. Yeah, yes. And this worms and environment go hand in hand. We cannot talk separately. So this, they don't like sunlight, and they need cool temperature, and keep away from rats, lizards, and this one, ants, that especially red ants, and protect from this rains, and keep them in a shade. Not in open air, in a shade, in anywhere in the balcony or somewhere. I am keeping one container even in my bathroom, which I am not using, under the this one sink. They don't come out. They don't come out. No fuss, nothing. If you feed them properly, they will be happy. If you keep them moist, then that much is enough. No smell, nothing. So you can keep it in your balconies also. Yeah. Yes. Next. Now I need to show the demo, this one.
Okay, so steps for preparation you want to do later?
Now finished, only demo now.
Okay. And this
everything I need to talk during demo only. Otherwise, they can't get it.
So I will stop the share for now. Okay. Okay. Yeah. Go ahead. Now you can show it.
Yeah. So this is, I have kept it for for you people to show this peels. There are food peels also, and there is this one. Mooli, and whatever you have at home, you can use like this. So how much you need to feed them, I will tell you later. Let me show the demo of the this one. How to make the bed first. And this is the container.
Not visible.
Wait, I'll show. So this is the container I have made ready for you people to show. I am using this this one, cardboards. You need to soak them, and you need to remove all the whatever is there, no? Colored paper and tape, whatever it is, you need to remove it. When it becomes soft, easily you can remove. You need to make them little more smaller pieces. I could not do that so small. How much smaller pieces you will make it, that is very much good. And I have taken this this one also. Soaked this one. What is this? Join audio, it is telling. Yeah. I am audible, no?
Yes.
Yeah. And I am taking this this soaked leaf. You soak it for 2-3 days. And then later you take half cocoa, this one, half this one, cardboard, and half leaf, and mix it well. So we have mixed it well like this. It should look like this. This much moist should be there in the container. Still, I have not released any earthworms in this. The container should be like this big. And this is one more container. This is already from 20 days. Already the earthworms have settled down. And you can see this, whatever you can see, this is the vermicompost. This is the African night crawlers. You can see this. The compost, vermicompost is the shape of the casting. It is long like this one, black rice. Can you see here? They are long. And here earthworms are there. They have settled down. These are ANC, African night crawlers. They are purplish in color, purplish and pink in color. They look like this. When sunlight falls on them, then they look a little bit of purplish and pinkish in color. Otherwise, they don't look so dark when there is light is not reflecting on them. And they are longer than red wigglers. And they multiply very fast, and they are like bakasura. They eat the stuff very fast, and they will give you vermicompost, more vermicompost than red wigglers. So if you are not at all comfortable touching these worms and all those stuff, then you can use the gloves. So this is the setup. It is a 20 days old container. Before it was looking like this, no casting, nothing. Now you can see the difference.
there is blackish color casting is there, right? So they have started consuming this one. And after 10 days, you can start feeding them the earthworms. So show me the PPT, Deepak. Can you hear me? Now worm bedding is finished, right? Now how to feed them? Okay. So how to feed them? If the earthworms are handful, then you need to feed them only handful of food. No overfeeding. Got it? If they are handful, no counting. 100 are there, 200 are there, no counting. If they are handful, then you need to give them only handful. And what happens? If you give them more, the container will start smelling it. It will start, stinging smell will happen. Then it will create a lot of heat. Because no, how much we eat, that much only we somebody has to feed us, right? I eat 2 to 3 chapatis. If they give me 10 chapati, how can I eat it? Not possible, right? So you need to feed only handful. One second. See, now here, spread a little bit there down, and I will take one handful. Sometimes if it is really soggy, then you put one cardboard, dry cardboard at the bottom, and I'll be adding little more because there are more earthworms in this container. Then I will close it like this completely, because fruit flies may come in. You don't see any fruit flies, anything. No, because I will be covering it properly. And these earthworms, microbes will start decomposing this. When the earthworms will come there, when this is half decomposed, that's why they have this bacteria and microbes in their system. So when the earthworms will come on the fourth day, not first day, fourth day or fifth day, you can see that the earthworms will be there, and they will finish this food in 1 week. In 1 week. And if before giving the next round, you need to go and check there whether food is there or what. You can see there is no food here. There is no food. Everything is consumed. That's why I am adding. Here, little bit is there. Yeah, little bit is there. But I need to show you people. That's why I am putting. Otherwise, everywhere it is, if you see, they have consumed. Only little bit I have given. You can see here, no? Only 2-3 pieces are there. So this is very much important. Only once in a week, not every day. Once in a week, if you are putting here, the next time should be here. The next time should be here. The fourth week should be here. So keep something to remember any of this, this one, coconut, that this one comes now, what you say? Shell, coconut shell. Keep one coconut shell here somewhere, or you use one some stick here. So you can make out where you have put the food. Then next time you need to put it in the another place. 1, 2, 3, 4. So once in a week, only after they are consumed. Otherwise, wait for 2-3 days. So this is the one very much important feeding the pot. This one, earthworms. Yeah. Then what is next, Deepak?
Yeah, how to release?
How to release the earthworms? If you have earthworms, your bed is ready here. What you need to do? Simply release them here. Can you see my hand? Simply release them here. Then just little bit, or you even you cannot, if you don't want, you don't, you need not to close them. Just little bit you need to put some cardboard like this and leave it. Immediately they don't get go into the bin, because they need to check whether enemies are there or what in the bin. If rats are there, lizards are there, whatever enemies are there, they will check with their smell. For 2-3 days, they don't move anywhere. You need not to be anxious or curious, or don't go and dig every day and see what they are doing. Please don't do that. Allow them to settle down for 1 week. Cover it with the wet cloth and cover it with the cardboard. Let them settle down. If this container is made out of leaf and cardboard, 100% I will tell you. I don't want to put it in 100%. 99.9 earthworms will settle down. They don't come out of the container. The only one thing you need to make sure, keep it moist for 1 week. Let the leaves heat released outside. Then only you need to release the earthworms. That is very much important. The heat should be released. The container should become cool. Then only you need to release. So before buying, you need to keep your container ready. खाना तो उनको ready रखना ही है. बाद में ही release करना है. Got it, everybody? These 2 points really matters for this earthworms. Okay? Yes. What is next?
Where to keep worm bin?
One second. या मुझे स्पॉटलाइट करो दीपक.
हाँ आपकी ओपन स्पॉटलाइट है.
हाँ हाँ. वन मोर थिंग इज यू नीड यू शुड नॉट स्कैटर देम ऑल ओवर इन दिस वन कंटेनर फूड स्पेशली. I told you, only you need to put it in the corner, because some people know they will scatter everywhere and they will, what happens, it will heat up the container, then they won't be having any place to hide themselves. That one you need to look into it. Okay, because I'm seeing if you have left something, that's why I'm checking my notes. Yes, I have covered everything. And and container should not be transparent. Container should not be transparent. I have shown you. It should be colored one, thick one, so that sunlight won't get into the container. That is very much important, because they are very sensitive to sunlight. The container should not be transparent. Yes. Now, I would like to show you the ready vermicompost. This is the ready vermicompost. Can you see?
Hello.
Some tweaks are there. You can see the ones. Here I have put the food in the container here in the corner, and you can see the worms. So you will see worms where there is food. They come only 4th or 5th day, not before that. In this container, red wigglers and African night crawlers, both are there. I am seeing more this one only, A and C. I need to look for the red, this one, red wigglers. Later, I will show you how they look. Recently, I have came to know about all these two varieties of earthworms. You need not be worried about which earthworm I need to take. Whatever you get it, you use it. All the earthworms will do their job perfectly. You need not be worried about that. So, yeah. Yes, now harvesting. Now harvesting, how I do this one is, I will bring all this vermicompost, everything I will pull it and put it in one side, then same bed, I will put it here, half of the container. Then what happens? All these earthworms will start coming here because I won't be feeding here because I want to collect the vermicompost. This is called migration method. Automatically, all the worms will come here because they need food. I don't feed them anything because this food is there ready. It is cool and they love it. Their favorite. What cardboard and leaves is very much favorite. So I will remove everything and then put it here, and I will half of the container and put with this leaves and cardboard. Then within 15 days, I can see all the worms will be here. Then without any worms, I can collect this vermicompost. Still, if they are left out, what to do? In the container, example, this I have harvested. Okay. I have harvested in another container. Especially take it a bucket. Bucket will have a very small mouth. So bucket, what you need to do? This watermelon. This watermelon is their favorite. I have made it into pieces. You need not to make it into pieces. Take big, big pieces. Okay, then put them here and cover it. Fifth day, you will see all tiny one, small one, big one will be here. Then easily you can collect it. How I showed you, easily they are here, right? They are here. So easily on top. And you can collect them. One method. One.
Your audio is not coming. Sumaji, are you there? Some audio problem is there. Just let me see.
Yes.
Yeah, now better.
Yeah,
now. Okay. So I will use my mobile. Huh? Yes, I'll use my mobile now. I don't know what happened. Dishu, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೋಡಪ್ಪ ಏನೋ ಇದಾಯ್ತು ಕನೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಅಲ್ಲೊಂದೆರಡು ಇದು ಇಟ್ಟಿನ ನೋಡು ಬಟ್ಟೆ ಬಕೆಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೀರ್ ತೆಗೆದು ತಗೊಂಬ. ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಡಿಬಲ್ ರೈಟ್? ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಸೀ ಮೀ?
ಯೆಸ್
ಯೆಸ್ ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಹಾರ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಅರ್ಥ್ ವಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್. Then the what is next is do and don't. Already I have told you what you need to do and what you need not to do. But still I would like to revise. Okay.
Okay.
Some echo is there now.
One device audio, you remove it actually. Then it will come. You're mute, unmute. Umaji, please unmute yourself.
Yes, yes. I'm audible now.
Yes. Mute.
Give me 2 minutes. Yeah. I will keep this also ready so that if anything goes wrong, then I can use this. Sorry for interruption. I don't know, something is wrong today. Yeah. So what is do and don't you need to do? So food wise, you people know, no? What you need to put it in the container, what will go into the container, what won't go into the container. That is in do and don't. And one more is you need to keep away from the rats and red ants, then lizards and all those stuff. Really you need to. This should take one babatte. I'll travel and spread maadi tosbekodu. That one is very important. You need to keep away from all the stuff. Then what else? Put the PPT, Deepak. Next. No excess food and stick to the mentioned environment. Now environment what I have told, and no bakery items and all those stuff, no non-veg and all those stuff, and cover the container with wet cloth. Okay. Aglamo. Cardboard to one. This is how you need to keep your container. Cover it with wet cloth like this. So whenever it dries up, little bit you need to sprinkle the water. So this is the way you need to keep. Then later you need to cover it with the cardboard like this. Because sunlight should not go into the container. This is the setup. This is how it looks. My job is done. So any questions, let me know. So these are the 5 things you people need to look into it. What is that 5 essentials? Would all the people If you are pakka with these 5 things, then go back. Container, material, food, worms, and environment. These 5 things, if you are pakka, then everything will be good and fine. Got it? Yes. Yep. If any questions,
yeah, let me know. We missed the covering because it was not spotlighted. We missed the covering the way you had covered it. If you can spotlight that, then we can see.
Yes. I will do.
Maybe Deepak Bhaiya can spotlight the other idea.
नहीं वो नहीं कर सकते मुझे ही करना है.
Yeah.
ये देखो ऐसा रहता है. ये मेरा old cover is there, pillow cover. This is old pillow cover I am using for this. This is wet. This is how you need to cover. Anything should make is okay. Old your cotton sari or
because it's not coming, it's only your face is coming.
Face is coming.
Yeah, तो आपको उमा जी की दूसरी जो आईडी है ना उसको
मुझे स्पॉटलाइट करना है दीपक.
नहीं एक ही डिवाइस है ना, दो डिवाइस नहीं है.
नहीं इट इज देयर,
दो डिवाइस है, अभी दो डिवाइस है.
वन सेकंड, आई एम लेट मी डू इट फॉर यू.
आप कर दीजिए. देखिए तो भाग दिख रहा है मुझे. नहीं
What's the time now? 6 o'clock, no?
Ho gaya. You can show it now.
Sharp 6. I have finished my this one. You people can come up with the questions. This is how it looks.
Oh, this is,
and you need to cover it with the cardboard like this.
Okay. Now we can see that.
Hi, Sarena.
Yeah. There were few questions. People were asking whether we should use neem leaves, lemon, garlic, onion, ginger, or we should avoid all that.
Onion, garlic. Yes, I left that one. Yeah, onion, garlic. If one or two, this one is okay. एक दो onion का छिलके चलेगा.
Okay.
But not this much.
Okay. What about buttermilk?
You spotlight me na, Deepak, laptop ka.
One second.
I'm there na. Itna sara chilke nahi dalne ka. Kuch festival bana ho gaya to itna sara chilke bacha hai, usme nahi jayega. One or two onion peels is okay. One or two mango peels is okay. One or two this one orange peels is okay. Wo juice bana diya ghar mein. तो इतना सारा है तो नहीं जाएगा, बिकॉज इट विल बिकम एसिडिक एंड दिस दे से ऑनियन एक्चुअली दे डोंट लाइक, बट व्हाट हैपेंड नो, इन माय गार्डन आई हैड मल्च्ड ऑल द कंटेनर्स विद द ऑनियन पीस टू गेट रिड ऑफ दिस मिल व्हाट इज दिस व्हाइट फ्लाइज एंड ऑल दिस मिली बग्स, बट आई कुड सी माय अर्थवर्म्स वर ईटिंग दिस ऑनियन पीस, बट स्टिल दे से बट I don't know whether they were very, nothing was there to eat, that's why they are eating, or I don't know. But they say they don't like these onion peels and this garlic peels. But citric, please don't put, because now it becomes, container becomes acidic. If container becomes acidic, then they don't stay in that container.
Any specific reason why not to use buttermilk and all?
Oh, buttermilk all acidic hai na.
अच्छा ओके फॉर एसिडिक. ओके
बटर मिल्क ऑल वो तो एसिडिक में आता है. एंड पनीर एंड ऑल ना दे डोंट ईट दिस पनीर एंड वो क्या होता है स्मेल शुरू हो जाएगा. ऑलराइट. डीकंपोज कुक्ड फूड इट टेक्स लॉट ऑफ टाइम. तो आप तो घर में रखते हैं तो इतना सारा स्मेल आएगा टिल देन इट डीकंपोज देन व्हाट इज पुअर थिंग विल डू देयर. बहुत सारे हीट भी हो जाएगा और वो स्मेल से फ्रूट फ्लाइज वगैरह आएगा. and all these other composting insects are there, no? They may come into the container. Woh din lag jayega, 15 days. One I checked, once I had put this rice, cooked rice. 15 din ho gaya, udari pada tha. It was there. For 15 days, because it did not decompose, no? These earthworms will eat half decompose. Fresh, okay. They don't eat. Composting, do composting. इनमें सारा मेरा compost में तो सब जाएगा, सब जाता है.
So most important question people are asking, where to get the earthworms?
हाँ, where to get earthworms in Bangalore? I can help you. I can share through this porter and all those stuff. In Bangalore, you can get in GKVK, and just see if anybody is there in and around. For your friends, or if you're using vermicompost in your container, there will be some earthworms. What you need to do, there is one container here, pot. I will show you what to do. This is the container, right? This is the container. What you need to do, dig a little bit here. थोड़ा सा डिग करो इधर, डिग लिटिल बिट, कीप इट मॉइस्ट, देन पुट सम वाटरमेलन्स. वाटरमेलन इज वेरी फेवरेट ऑफ दिस अर्थवर्म्स. थोड़ा सा, ज्यादा नहीं. पुट लिटिल बिट ऑफ दिस वन. ओ, स्पॉटलाइट करो दीपक.
हाँ, किया था, चला गया, पता नहीं.
हाँ, मेरे प्लेट का स्पॉटलाइट करो. सो डोंट पुट मोर, बिकॉज नो इट मे हीट अप द कंटेनर आल्सो. टेक लिटिल बिट, नॉट मी, वो दूसरा को. हाँ, दे कैन सी बोथ ना.
हाँ हाँ, यस,
ऑल आर ऑफ यू, सब में दे कैन सी, नो? या. So take little bit and put it in the container and close it with the soil. Fifth day, if you dig, you can see the earthworms, if earthworms are there in the containers. In that way, last year we had 30 plus people did the vermicompost. Just collecting from the containers. So in that way, you can make use of this water. Even if you get this much also is okay. You can start your bin. Almost last year summer, I think so, I took this workshop in the WhatsApp. Everybody got some earthworms from their containers and they started. That is one. in your local area, go to the horticulture and find out. Now it is lockdown, you may not go there. If anybody is there in and around, or if you are there in any groups, ask them, there you can get it. In Bangalore, I will help you. I can share my earthworms for you. Last year also I shared. So I can do that one also. Porter is there. If you are installing porter, first two, this one, you really, they will give a lot of discount. Make use of it.
Yeah, yeah. And one question actually is there about the earthen pots. Whether the mud-based pot can be used for this kind of things instead of...
Yeah, yeah, I'm not able to hear. Yeah, tell me.
Earthen pot.
What earthen course?
Earthen pot.
That material.
वो मिट्टी का बर्तन.
वो clay का. Clay. Earthen pots.
Yes. Clay pots.
Earthen pots, you can use it, but both generally dry hota hai. You need to keep on putting this one. You need to keep it moist.
Oh.
Keep it moist. But the only thing is, for beginners, I don't recommend all this stuff. Because you don't know how to take care of the earthworms. अर्थन पॉट्स का तो माउथ तो इतना छोटा रहता है, इट वोंट बी बिग वन. इफ इट गेट बिग वन इट विल बी सिलिंड्रिकल शेप. सो यू माइट गो रॉन्ग. बेटर टेक वन स्मॉल टब, टब ले लो, उसमें शुरू करो. देन यू गेट सम लिटिल बिट ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस, देन यू कैन स्टार्ट देयर. बिकॉज द ओनली थिंग इज वो हीट नहीं होना चाहिए. Because the earthworms cannot move around. They need to move around. They need some space now. So you are a beginner means wait for a while. Two in the container, which is which bigger mouth in tubs or in such kind craters. Then later you can switch on to clay pots. Tab tab to aap thoda expert ban jayenge na.
Yes.
Then you can. Someone has asked for
this one concerned about the earthworms. So better you follow this what instruction, because this what I'm sharing is this I have done with myself in the beginning, and also I'm continuing it, and it is really going very well. So first start with this such method, then later on you can switch on to other things. Yeah.
Someone was asking how to use the tea powder thing. Should we wash so that
because थोड़ा wash करके रखना अच्छा है. What I do, I have made one container with the lid. Wash करो उसमें डालो, wash करो थोड़ा पानी वगैरह जो भी है निकाल दो, remove the water and put it in the container. वो तो इतना हो जाएगा ना, तो एक week का 10 दिन का हो जाएगा, तो it already half decomposed inside. So it is ready to use for, ready to eat. What we say, no, ready to eat. Aisa rehta hai. So you can use it in that way also. Regularly if you want to put, that is also very good. No problem.
Yes. Someone asked about the leaf. Any leaf is okay? For example,
leaf. Any leaf is okay. Any leaf is okay. Even you can put neem leaf also. No problem. But it should be in a balanced way. Only neem nahi dalne ka. Jo bhi milta hai na. रोड साइड में सारा लीफ मिलता है, सभी कलेक्ट करो और कलेक्ट ऑल द लीव्स व्हाट एवर यू सी ना इन एंड अराउंड, कलेक्ट इट एंड यूज इट, बिकॉज ऑल द लीफ कंटेन्स समथिंग और द अदर न्यूट्रिशन विल बी देयर. दैट इट इज वेरी गुड. इफ यू पुट लिटिल मोर नीम इज ओके, बिकॉज इट बिकम्स लिटिल बिट ऑफ मोर गुड फॉर दिस वन इंसेक्ट्स. बट थोड़ा बैलेंस रखो, कीप इट बैलेंस. इवन वी ईट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फ्रूट्स वेजिटेबल्स, दिमाग लगाओ भाई कैसे करना है, कितना एंट्स है, क्या है, कुछ देखना पड़ेगा.
एंड वन थिंग इज दैट डोंट पुट द कुक्ड फूड. इफ कुक्ड फूड इज देयर देन मोर इट विल कम, राइट? एंड
हां, इफ कुक्ड फूड इज नॉट देयर देन जनरली एंट्स वोंट कम. अदरवाइज इट्स अ कंटेनर, मींस कीप समथिंग डाउन एंड पुट सम वाटर. आई थिंक सो, यू डोंट बी सो मच ऑफ कैओस और प्रॉब्लम विद द एंट्स. आई हैव नॉट सीन हु आर इनटू दिस वर्मी कंपोस्ट. वो एंट्स आ गए ऐसे नहीं है, स्पेशली लिजर्ड्स विल कम, एंट्स तो थोड़ा कम ही है.
समवन आज आस्किंग अबाउट ओपन टेरेस, कीपिंग ओपन टेरेस एक्चुअली एनी प्रिकॉशन और हाउ इट इज ओपन टेरेस.
नीड टू कीप इट क्लोज्ड बिकॉज़ दे डोंट लाइक सनलाइट. इफ सनलाइट फॉल्स ऑन द कंटेनर, बिकॉज एट नाइट ऑल्सो दे मूव अराउंड, डे टाइम ऑल्सो इफ यू कीप इट क्लोज दे मूव अराउंड, दे कम ऑन टॉप. And again they don't go down. If it is and it, the container becomes make become dry and sunlight may sunlight means even this light, no, there is no sunlight, but this bright light also will be affecting those poor things. So you need to keep it close, then only they will do their job properly. Otherwise no, they will settle down and without food they may die. So very very important, you need to close the container, not airtight. In our India, our temperature is around from 20 to 48, 50 degree, right? in other extreme countries, the temperature is something different, the method is something completely different there. Here, we have some moderate and extreme climates. So, there we need to close the containers with the cardboard, not airtight. With the airtight means they will suffocate. Even we breathe, even they breathe. So, they are not toys, no. Really, we need to take care of them. So, this cardboard is enough for them. Air ventilation sab rahega, andar sunlight nahi jayega, to aram se rahenge andar.
Yes, anything. Cardboard pe there was one question is there. Should the cardboard should be put in water, soak in water before putting? That is the one.
Yes. I have told, no, you need to soak in water for one day. They become very soft. So mash it properly so that it becomes very soft. Break it, put a breaker, then what later? I've showed you, no? In that way, it should be there. And thoda water content should be there in the cardboard. Pura pani nikal ke nahi dalne ka. Just take it, little bit squeeze it, extra water goes, then put it in the.
Yes. There are some questions in material like what is the proportion, any proportion to be taken care in leaves or this?
With respect to cardboard.
You better start with these four material. One is cocopeat, one is leaf, one is soil, and one is
cardboard.
Yeah. Any two, half of.
Okay.
And can the persons who have their, compost, so can they use their, things in the compost? That was the question. No. Okay.
Why I tell you? Because you all are beginners. And if you are not doing compost properly, maggots will be there. If these maggots will enter this bin, if you put food today, they will be there second day. They will eat everything. Nothing will be left for the earthworms, number one. Number two, these maggots will increase the acidity in the container. Container will become acidic. Then these poor things really, they will suffer. I am not doing any experiments now. Because some, even though if there are, you don't see maggots, some eggs will be there.
Yeah.
Wo bada ho jayenge bhai andar. Within no time. You see everywhere, all maggots will be there. Then this poor thing will start coming out because a lot of heat is there. Because if you put it inside, if you put your finger inside, you can feel it warm. The container become warm. How can they stay in the warm container? Heat is there, acidic, no food. Then you think about the condition of these earthworms. In YouTube and all, they show, do half composted food. The compost, usme dalo, wo acche rahenge. But I am not doing. I have done it and really.
Yeah.
In the bean, actually, there are.
Meena Krishnamurthy. There is one lady called Meena Krishnamurthy in Bangalore. She stays in Jayanagar. She does really wonderful composting. You don't even see one maggot in her container. Such people can use the half compost. But I am not so good in compost. I do composting. Maggots will be there. I leave them when the compost is ready. I will use for the containers. But I don't use for my containers. So I recommend beginners don't use it. Later you, on your own, when you become expert, you know what to do. Yeah.
So
beginners, no.
Okay.
In the bean, there are questions is there that... container, whether any water outlet is needed in that, and how much is to be filled. Water outlet is needed in the container.
See, I have not kept any holes in the containers. It becomes really mess because I do simple way. If you use such material, there won't be any soggy. If at all it becomes soggy, keep some cocopeat at home. Okay. dry cocoa pit thoda sa andar jo bhi kaha rehta hai dal do. See, when you start managing it na, when it becomes soggy, if you don't keep cardboard inside in the container, then it becomes soggy because cardboard will absorb the excess water. So sure. That's what I'm telling. No, when you put in any corner, keep 2-3 pieces of cardboard. Then on that you keep this food
layering.
Vegetable piece. Not layering.
Okay.
Just yes. you keep place 2-3 cardboard, small one.
Mm-hmm.
Big this much big. Then on that you put this vegetable peels. Then cover it with the bed, whatever you have, or vermicompost. Then what happens? Whatever water is there, it is absorbed by this cardboard. Then the container won't become soggy. And they will eat the food also, they will eat this cardboard also, and in between the cardboard they will lay eggs, then they will do their mating and whatever it is, happens in between these cardboards.
Okay.
So all beneficial, yeah.
Some yes, question, can they use the coconut husk?
Yeah. Coconut husk we can use. Soak them in water for a few days, then remove it, and whatever dust is there, that also you take it and put it in the container. You can use it, no problem.
Someone wanted your PDF file, I mean PPT. Are you sharing that?
Come again and join the...
Can be and get enriched microbes.
These 5 things, if you keep it in your mind, that is enough, I tell you. Container, material, food, and then what else?
Environment.
Food, then
cardboard.
Worms, how to take care of the worms, and then environment.
Yeah.
If you remember these 5 things, enough. So I would like to summarize in 2 minutes. Container should be broader mouth, tub or crater, then food. Only fruit peels and vegetable peels and tea powder, coffee powder and eggshells. How to feed them? Once in a week.
Okay.
And this much earthworms, this much food. Once in a week. And check before the next week, before feeding them, whether food is left out or what. Accordingly, you need to put the second round. So once in a week, 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't put it in the same place. And don't mix it like visible bath. No. In one corner.
Okay.
Food. Okay. Then what else? Worms. Then cover it properly. No sunlight should go. Even bright light should not go inside. Then environment should be dark place is very good. And no, this one, rain water should not go inside. And keep away from the enemies. Then what else? Yeah, material, any 2 you can use.
Yeah.
You can choose 3 also, 4 also, no problem. If you get the cardboard and leave, that is the very best, I tell you. Immediately, within 1 hour, they will go inside. And if they're still staying there, then don't worry. They will settle down. So if you're using the soil, make sure you add cocoa peat little bit or this dry leaf is very, very much important. Cardboard also use in the soil, no problem. So leaf cardboard or leaf cocoa peat. If you are using leaf, something should be there to bind the leaves to keep it moist. Either cardboard or cocoa peat is very much essential.
Okay.
Then what else? Cardboard leaf is there. Cardboard soil is okay. Cardboard and leaf is okay. Soil and cocoa peat is okay. If there is soil, cocoa peat is a must.
Okay.
If you are using dry leaf, 4 pot of dry leaf. Because it becomes too hard. Only if you use soil, it's okay. But it becomes too hard to dig and also all those stuff. So better to use 2 to 3 to 4 portion of leaf or cardboard or cocoa peat. Anything will go. No problem at all. because they are close to nature and they love this material, earthworms will love this material and they settle down very fast and it keeps the container cool. That is very important. Yes, then what else?
They were asking about the number of earthworms as per the proportion of your cardboard and the, you know,
you take off. See, if you put more bed, they take more time to consume. That's all. थोड़ा ज्यादा देखो कंटेनर इतना बड़ा है तो इसके लिए तो इतना काफी है.
Okay.
I showed this container, no, in my container, which is already have put the earthworms. There are 100 earthworms. They are doing well. थोड़ा ज़्यादा होगी तो कुछ
नहीं. Because Jay sir is raising his hand, maybe he
has. Because see, if you have bed enough bed, they can move around. They can move around. They can do multiply faster. थोड़ा ही है, थोड़ा छोटा है तो देर इज नो स्पेस फॉर देम टू मूव अराउंड एंड इफ यू आर कीपिंग फूड इन वन कॉर्नर एंड देर इज नो स्पेस फॉर देम टू रेस्ट एंड हीट इज रिलीज्ड व्हाट इज हीट इज अक्यूमुलेटेड लॉट इन द कंटेनर सो ब्रॉडर कंटेनर इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट अकॉर्डिंगली यू पुट द बेड नो प्रॉब्लम अच्छा रहेगा ना बड़ा घर है तो अच्छा रहता है ना व्हाट यू से वन स्मॉल रूम बिगर हाउस For us, how we feel? Nice, nice. Same with the earthworms. Chana jyada dalu usme kya hai?
Right.
They'll be happy.
Yes. One more question is there about that height of how much in a container full filling is.
Height should not be more than 2.5 feet. One more I left out. Which we use this height should be not more than 2.5 feet. And one more I left is whatever earthworms we are using now, they stay in the top soil between 3 to 4 feet. They don't go deeper in the soil. In natural environment, I'm telling, in forest or wherever, they just go deep, just 3 to 4 feet. More than that, they don't go. And they consume only biomass more.
It's
less soil. That's why we are using only that earthworms in the containers because we want to use vegetable peels so that it doesn't go into the landfill. That is also very important. And these will settle down very fast in the containers because they don't go very deep now. If you start searching for deep, which go very deep, that is 10 feet and 20 feet, or 15 feet, they may not be comfortable in the containers because they want to go deep. And your container is very this one. And if you're using cylindrical also doesn't comfortable because there is no space for them to go around. Nah?
Heat so is accumulated. Interesting question coming your way. Can they use cow dung? Can they use cow dung for feeding earthworms?
Not for the bigness. Second round you can use. When you bring any cow dung, keep it for 1 month.
Yeah.
Before 1 month, you should not use it. After 1 month, make it a slurry. Okay. And add all your dry leaves, cardboard, everything for some time. For 2-3 days. Then put it in the container.
Yeah, interesting question, how frequently they multiply the earthworm?
3 months they will multiply double or triple.
Okay.
And some questions are coming that when they will see the result, like your compost is ready, how much time it takes to or progress?
According to how much earthworms you have, how much they multiply, in that accordingly it depends.
And you can see the progress anyway. Every week you can see some changes in that.
See, I have showed this red, yellow color, na? It is just 1 month old, 1.5 month old. They multiplied very fast and they consumed the food very fast because this time I added more leaf and more cardboards in this container, yellow one, which I showed it is ready, na?
Earth, yeah.
this one is ready. Within 2 months, if you start adding little, you need to keep on adding this leaves, dry leaves means soaked leaf, not dry leaf means not direct leaf. Soaked dry leaf and cardboard, soaked dry cardboards. If you keep on adding them, then what happens? They poop more. They multiply more. Then your this will be what? This is just 1.5 or 2 months old. Because this time I added more leaf, soaked leaf and more card, soaked dry cardboards. So that really helps a lot to poop more and I could get more vermicompost. Otherwise, it is to take me lot of time. So this time I did this one. So it's really very going very well. Yes.
So now the can we open for the one to voice based call also? Is it fine?
Yeah, open it, but let them raise their hands. Otherwise, no. I think so. We have covered everything.
Yes.
But for the beginner, I tell you, just start with these four material.
So
don't experiment on earthworms.
So that there is a hand raise is there. I will just.
Jay sir wanted to ask.
Are you able to unmute? Yes.
Yeah. Hello.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, ma'am. Just wanted to know what happens in case for 2 or 3 weeks we don't put any new material for the worms to feed. In case like we are traveling or. You know, due to some reason, what happens then? Suppose the entire compost is ready. There is no new material put. Phir kya hoega?
Then you need to plan accordingly. What you need to do? Collect dry leaves, these cardboards, soak them properly, fill the container completely. For 1 month, no problem, but somebody has to sprinkle the water. Because it should not go dry. So frequently somebody has to sprinkle the water. One thing. And one more thing is, if you really are not coming for 2-3 months and no one is there to take care of them, if you have any pots or somewhere, somebody is there, Mali or somebody who can water them, then you need to put them in the in the containers where there are plants. So, if you are coming after 15 days, then keep it thoroughly, thoda sa moist rakho. This dry leaf and this cardboards moist, if you keep it, then really they will be happy for 21 months also, no problem. But thoda kabhi kabhi aake thoda dekhna chahiye na, because they are living beings. They are not toys. That much you need to take care.
Can we use the combination of cocoa pit?
One more thing we can do. If you have any friends, तो उसके घर में कहीं तो रख दो तो बोल लो थोड़ा पानी डालते sprinkle करते रहो. Then when you come back, you can take your container. That also you can do. Yeah.
Can we use the combination of cocoa pit, leaves, and cardboard?
Cocoa
pit
leaves and cardboards, no problem.
Okay, fine.
Thank you. And
in these four, anything will go in these four material, anything will go with anything.
Okay.
No problem at all.
Fine.
So
fine.
I have selected in a such a way, it won't go wrong.
Equal measures, we can put it. Equal measures.
Yes, yes.
Paper, newspaper, someone was asking, is it okay?
No newspapers, because that all color are there and so many, they say it is now, it is safe, but anyway, it is chemical, right? We are putting this to our vegetables, so this vermicompost, and we are consuming it, so better not to use newspapers.
Anyone has the question, please raise the hand if you want to speak and ask the question.
Is there a YouTube video of Umaji recorded? People were asking.
I think so. I have not. I have one YouTube channel. I keep posting so many things. One second.
In WhatsApp, you can share it, this one.
No, if no one is there, if anybody has directly come into the YouTube, and if are not in the WhatsApp, you can leave your numbers there. We will add you into the WhatsApp, and I will give my YouTube channels everything. Okay, I'm not. Whatever I learn, I keep on adding in YouTube channel. If people can go whenever you're free, you can go and watch this. Right now, I'm not putting this recorded one about the vermicompost. If anybody's interested, they need to join live.
This micro fly.
One more thing, I will be helping you people for 1 month. Huh? For 15 days or 10 days, you people go around and see what how can you can collect the earthworms and collect all these materials. Then we will be keeping the group muted. Otherwise, so many unnecessary, so many things if they put in, it becomes a problem for everybody. Then I will open it after every week. Every week weekend I'll open it, and whatever questions you have, we can go through that. Then I will help you with the setup, and if anything goes wrong or whatever is there, I will help you for 1 month. Then we will wind up. Is it okay, everybody?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, someone has raised the hand. I'm sorry actually that I missed. Can you raise the hand again?
Jay, sir.
Jay has already asked a question.
He has another question regarding microbes.
Okay. Mira has one more question.
Yes.
Hello, ma'am. This is Shilpa here.
Hi, Shilpa.
Thank you, ma'am. The session was very wonderful. Thank you so much for your time and patience. I learned a lot of things. I had one question. I was just wondering, like you said, to do the bedding with leaves and cardboard, correct? So now daily, if I'm not able to add these vegetable peels and all as top-up food, can I just keep adding soaked dry leaves?
Yes, or no problem.
Will it be a problem? Because I do have a lot of dry leaves, so I thought if I put it in the wormy bin, then will it help?
Very, it helps a lot, and you'll get vermicompost very early, actually. But why we recommend all this stuff means this kitchen waste should not go to the landfill. So, and also the earthworms also love it. That's why we recommend use this one.
Okay. I'm doing kitchen composting separately. So for only for the worms, I was thinking I'll keep this.
Yeah, you can use. And little bit of cardboards, because no top leaves will dry very fast because of this aeration, air and all those stuff. If you keep a little bit cardboard also in that, no?
Like
it keeps the container moist.
Okay, ma'am. Yes. Thank you so much. Yes.
You can use more leaf and less cardboard also, no problem. Match them, no? Soak them, these cardboards, for 2-3 days. Then really you can mash it and mix it with the leaves. Even though if you have less cardboard also, it goes well. It's a binding for the leaf. Something should be there, no? To keep it moist. Yeah.
Yeah, Chandanji, go ahead.
I would like to thank Shilpa. Last time we did the workshop for 1 hour without any PPT presentation. She really guided me how to make the presentation and all those stuff. Because I sit and I take the workshops and I guide them. But this time I really thought she gave me some suggestions. So many people doesn't know what is vermicompost. They don't know what is earthworms. And cocoa peat also, so many people don't know. So why don't you make all this presentation and all those stuff? So then there was one more lady. She messaged me, I can't hear. I can't hear. I can see. Then I thought, for such people, really, they need something material. No. So we sat together and we did. Thank you, Shilpa, for that. Yeah. Yeah. Anything else?
Yes, madam.
YouTube channel link.
Chandanji, want
to? I will put it in the WhatsApp group.
Chandanji,
has a question. Let me see. Madam. It is possible. दीपक मैं तुमको दे देती हूँ, तुम थोड़ा डाल दो हाँ चैट बॉक्स में.
ठीक है ठीक है.
जय सर, इफ यू कैन पुट योर क्वेश्चन इन द चैट बॉक्स.
आई थिंक सो एवरीथिंग इज कवर्ड राइट.
या और एल्स दीपक, दीपक भैया यू कैन अनम्यूट, हेल्प हिम अनम्यूट. जय सर वांट्स टू, यू नो, ही हैज बीन ट्राइंग फॉर अ व्हाइल.
This microfight.
Deepak, I have forward. Deepak, I have forward your my YouTube channel.
Yes,
you can put that in the link in chat box. Hmm?
Yeah. Okay, so Chandan ji.
In the YouTube as well as in the Zoom.
Yes, yes.
Chandan, I don't post in the YouTube's. Okay, so whenever I see some good is going on in my garden and some experiments I keep on doing. For the soil and all those stuff, and even for this earthworms, I'll be not every week. Hmm? So just keep on subscribe, and yeah. I you can
posted it in the group WhatsApp channel. It is posted.
Yeah. Anything else?
And Chandan ji has some waiting.
Yes, ma'am. Madam.
Huh? Yeah.
Madam, Chandan from Malur, madam.
Yes, yeah, tell me.
Yeah, madam, I am doing that vermicompost. And I have the using the straws, madam, to mulching that thing. Madam, are you listening?
Yes, yes, I'm listening. Yeah, tell me. Yeah.
Oh, madam, already I am using the straws and dry leaves and something and all. But that is multiplying around of the 18 days into 3 times, madam. For 18 days, it is multiplying for 3 times.
That is very good, no? If you have more earthworms, then separate, make into half and make one more container.
I'm already distributed for the round of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Already I shifted to the 6 bags, madam.
It in your chat. See, you can do one more thing. You can share the earthworms to the other people who want to start the earthworms.
Madam, already shared it that in WhatsApp group, that is the worms already. And already you have spoken with me at night, madam. Last 3 days back.
Okay. See, if you have very big containers, no, that really goes very well. If you have more
earthworms. I will show the video.
Nowadays, you get this grow bags, na?
No, madam.
Width will be 2 feet and height will be 2.5 and length will be 24. Such things you can use and you can do. You can share with the other people if you have more.
No, madam. 1 second, madam. I'll show you, madam. See, madam.
Yeah. Till then, any other questions?
Microflies are there around my place. Microflies.
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 Any or two microflies you want?
Madam,
small.
What flies. Microflies?
It is like a fly. It's a small one. It is around my place.
See, we are talking, discussing only about the earthworms.
No. Because it touches the surface everywhere. Will it affect this bin? The microflies will affect our, yeah.
What is this micro? Bin. There are flies. What is this microflies?
Very small one. It's a small one.
Are these food flies?
Yeah, food flies.
fruit flies don't harm these earthworms, but you all around they will fly na at home or in the garden.
Yeah, yeah.
You need to cover this vegetable peels properly, then fruit flies won't get into the bin.
Okay, fine.
See, if you are not closing the vegetable peels properly, then only fruit flies will come. If you close it properly, these fruit flies won't come there. And within 4 days, all these bacteria will go and break the this one vegetables, and immediately within 1 week, gone. Your vegetables is gone from the dust, this one, from the bin.
Okay.
And where this fruit flies will survive in this container? Not possible.
Okay.
Only one method is need to cover it properly.
Okay. Fine.
But in the composting also, if you are doing composting, you need to cover it properly with the dry leaves. Then this fruit flies won't come. Yeah, you are showing me. Yeah, show me. उसको थोड़ा स्पॉटलाइट लगा दो दीपक ऑल ऑफ यू प्लीज कीप योर स्पीकर म्यूटेड you post me later. I did not get your name. You post me later in the WhatsApp.
Okay,
I will guide you. Yeah, fine. Any other questions? Can we wind up now? It's already 7 o'clock.
Madam, I want to ask one question.
Huh?
Can we use buttermilk to moisten the bedding?
I told you no any milk products are not allowed in the bin because it creates lot of acidic in the container.
Okay, what about jaggery syrup?
Why you want to add jaggery syrup?
That increases the microbes in the bin.
Not needed because earthworms have all type of microbes which helps to break down the vegetables. In the beginning, I have mentioned, right? What vermicompost contains. Vermicompost contains lot of microbes and lot of good bacteria, which are very good for your plants and which is very good for your vegetable peels to break down. Wo uske body mein bahut sare hai. N number of varieties of microbes are there. You need not to add jaggery. If you add jaggery, you will attract ants. Why you want to do that? See, nature is provided everything for the earthworms. They will do their job. You need not to worry.
Okay, madam. One more question is, after we get the casting...
One second. If you use this vermicompost, you need not to even use this... Jeevamrita. What Jeevamrita contains? It contains microbes, right? This vermicompost contains lot of lakhs together varieties of microbes, which are very good beneficial for the plants. So this one thing is enough for you.
Will it increase the acidity of soil?
What?
Using earth worm casting, will it increase the acidity of soil?
No, it doesn't increase any acidic in the soil. It is very good. In the beginning only I have mentioned. It doesn't increase any acid. It is neutral. If you add a little more also, it doesn't burn the plants. This is very good for the beginners who are doing gardening or whatever it is. Very good and contains lot of bacteria. You Google it and see.
Yeah. Now, after we get the casting, after we get the castings, can we use it directly to plants or should it wait for about 15-20 days?
Not necessary. You can use it. You can keep it for one week and you can use it.
What is the reason for keeping it for 1 week?
You can keep it. No expiry date for the organic manure. How old that is good for the this all this manual doesn't have any expiry date. Itna old hoga utna acha hai. This vermicompost also immediately if you use it, it doesn't burns the plants. That is the beauty of the vermicompost. It is not like cow dung. Fresh cow dung means it really kills the plants. This vermicompost won't kill the plants.
Okay, madam. Thank you.
Thank you, Maji. It was a lovely session.
Thank you. You all people joined. Really, I'm so happy. Please make use of this workshop. Okay. Post, keep posting anything. If you want earthworms, let us help each other. Huh? Yeah. Once again, we'll meet some other workshop with some. I would like to take some with about the microbes, how to increase microbes in the soil. Simple techniques. Jo bhi dal hai ghar mein, wo use karo aur increase karo. Such simple techniques which all are there at home. Nahi, nothing buy karne ka jaruri nahi hai. How to increase the nutrition of the this one. And we will take about the waste decomposer. Waste decomposer is the best, I tell you. It is made out of naughty. This desi cow cow dung. Okay. They have extracted some microbes from the cow dung. This is Ghaziabad NCOF, natural, long form.
Natural center of
organic. Ghaziabad, they have made this waste decomposer. That's really very good. I'm using it. I make pesticide out of that. I make nutrition out of that. Everything really. Plants grow very well and you get very
so looking good. Looking forward to your next session then on microbes and microgreens.
Yes. Microbes really we need to really learn because one more thing I would like to tell issue. One second, please. I would like to tell about the microbes. Microbes is the soul of the plant and soil because they cook the food for the plants. Whatever microbes excretes, whatever they poop, that is the food for the plants. Not this manure. If you don't put manure also, if there are microbes in the soil, they break down whatever is there in the soil. They are interconnected. They are very good friends, plants and these microbes. Oh, bolega, mujhe kuch ho gaya hai. Disease aa raha hai. To go search in the soil. Which is the medicine for the plants, it will break down, it will eat, it will poop, and it will give the nutrition to the plant. As a reward, this plant will give the sugar juice for the microbes. That's why we add jaggery. That's why we add jaggery for this cow dung.
Cow dung,
That is a sugar, nothing but sugar. But that sugar is something different, which the plants will give to the microbes. Microbes is the cook for the plants. Sab kuch hai, grocery hai. Khana nahi pakaye to how you eat? So this is the very much important. Vermicompost will do that job. Kuch dimag lagana nahi hai. वर्मी कंपोस्ट बनाओ, हैप्पी रहो,
घर पे खाना उगाओ. ओके, थैंक यू.
ओके देन विद दिस फाइव थिंग्स कीप इट इन माइंड. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर गिविंग. या अर्चना जी, आई एम टेलिंग समथिंग.
या आई एम सेइंग लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड फॉर योर नेक्स्ट माइक्रो ग्रीन वर्कशॉप. इट वाज वंडरफुल. थैंक यू.
Yeah, it was actually very nice session. So many people joined and so many questions was there.
How many are there, Ba? How many people joined?
We will disconnect the YouTube channel. Okay.
Deepak, wait. Totally, how many are there? Did you take some pictures or not? अरे सब लोग थोड़ा video on करो भाई, थोड़ा देखेंगे.
You will disconnect the YouTube.
Switch on your videos, no?
My video is there.
No, he is asking.